positive action. Mrs. Hot and Cutie the Cougar are back today, and look who we have. We have Miss Fox. Look, we matched.
We do.
Can you tell everybody hi?
Hi.
Hey, I'm so glad you're here today, because today we are talking for Teacher Talking Tuesdays. Is it okay if we ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
Awesome. All right, the first thing we want to share with the children, I want you to think back a long, long time ago, okay?
Okay.
All right. Got when you were a little girl, what did you want to be when you grow up?
Wow. I actually wanted to be a lot of stuff.
Cool.
I had a very favorite show when I was a kid. There was two of them. One was about like emergency medical people, and they would go around and save lives, so I really wanted to be a 911 dispatcher. And then I also really wanted to be a cashier at a grocery store.
Oh.
It was based on a television show I used to watch, so I actually did that one.
You did?
Yes.
Really? My sister-in-law was a cashier at a grocery store too. That's a hard job.
It is.
You know what? You guys might know somebody who's a cashier or a 911 dispatcher, and that's me.
And they both had a lot of responsibility.
Lots of responsibility. So you had some dreams, things you wanted to be, and you know what? Sometimes our dreams change, right? And now you're a teacher.
I'm a teacher.
And look at that, guys. It's cool. We want all of you guys to think. Try things. It's a positive action, and it's good for your brain to try new things. But tell us about being a teacher. Do you use positive actions as a teacher?
I use positive actions all the time as a teacher.
Oh, cool. Can you tell us, what are some of the positive actions you do, as a teacher and to get to be a teacher?
So, in order to be a teacher, you have to graduate high school, and you have to work really hard at that too. And then I went to college for 4.5 years to become a teacher.
Where'd you go?
I went to Frostburg State University, and I graduated in 2012. And I had a lot of homework that I had to be responsible, and my parents didn't make sure I did my homework or turned it in. That was my job to do. So I did all my homework and all these big projects, and I graduated, and then I had to apply for a job here, and I've been here ever since, but that was even a lot of responsibility, because usually my parents did everything when I was younger, and I had to fill out the job application, I had to make sure I was here on time, I had to be presentable and be responsible and respectful to Mr. Cable, who interviewed me, and it took a lot of hard work, and thankfully that's where I am today, so.
Thankfully, we have you here today, right? That's beautiful. So all of that hard work, you know what? I think you guys, all that stuff that Ms. Fox had to do, being responsible, getting your projects done, and she did all of that as a college student. Don't you guys do that in third grade also? Those are positive actions, and it's helping you today for what you can become tomorrow. Maybe a teacher like Ms. Fox.
Maybe.
Can I ask you one more question?
Sure.
Okay. Can you tell the children what inspires you every day to come to Warm Springs Intermediate?
Well, of course, it's all the kids that go here. I always tell my kids that once you're in my class, you're always going to be my child. So I don't care if you're 30 years old, you will always be mine. And it's them that I come to school for.
That's beautiful. So. Yeah, because you know what? Ms. Fox's classroom is a community, right? This is our family here. When you come to third grade every day, and your school is your community, so just remember that. She cares about you, and we are community cougars that care. That's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, we gotta get going, so say bye.
Bye.
Have a positive day.
I am a positive action kid. That's what I am. That's how I live.